Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. Today I will be sharing my opinion on the Artillery SideWinder X-2 3D printer. I've been using this printer for the last few weeks, so I thought I will make another video to share with you what I really like about this printer and some of the issues that I faced. This printer has gained a quiet reputation since its release, and I'm here to let you know if it lives up to the hype. So let's dive right in. First, let's talk about the pros of this machine. As you know, the Artillery SideWinder X2 is the improved version of the X1, and it brings some fantastic features to the table. The performance of the SideWinder X2 3D printer is commendable. With its sturdy frame and robust construction, it provides reliable and consistent printing results. The printer boasts a large build volume of 300x300x400mm, allowing for the creation of relatively large objects with ease. Additionally, the SideWinder X2 has a fast printing speed of 150mm/s, and it has maximum travel speed of 250mm/s, reducing the overall printing time for complex models. The printer is compatible with various filaments, including PLA, ABS, and PETG. Compared to the SideWinder X1, this was a great choice to replace the 8-bit motherboard with a 32-bit motherboard. The motherboard itself looks very small in the spacious 3D printer base. However, this helps with the cooling, which is handled by a single 80mm 24-volt fan. The 32-bit motherboard includes slots for the stepper motor drivers, making them easy to replace in the future when needed. One of the standout features of SideWinder X2 is its user-friendly interface and straightforward setup process. The printer comes 95% assembled, minimizing the effort required for initial setup. The touchscreen interface is spontaneous and easy to navigate, making it simple for users to operate the printer. The SideWinder X2 also includes automatic bed leveling, which eliminates the need for manual adjustments and ensures optimal print quality. However, I did face some issues with this, and I will talk about this later on in this video. Artillery 3D printers are known for having a neat look. With many low-budget 3D printers, the cabling is often very messy and has to be brought under the control with cable ties. With the SideWinder X2, all cables are already pre-assembled and only a few connections have to be plugged in during assembly. This means only less cables are used and the ribbon cables look professional and tidy. The print quality produced by SideWinder X2 is exceptional. It offers high-resolution printing, resulting in detailed and precise prints. The printer's direct drive extruder and all-metal hot end contribute to the accurate filament control, reducing the risk of clogging and filament inconsistencies. The SideWinder X2's heated bed provides excellent adhesion, reducing the chances of warping and detachment during the printing. Overall, the printer consistently delivers smooth and visually appealing prints. Having said that, I also had some print quality issues which I will be talking about later and how I solved this. For a mid-range 3D printer, the resume print feature is a must. With this feature, the 3D printer remembers the point of the 3D print where it was interrupted by an unexpected power failure. With the resume print feature, you don't have to worry about the 3D print being ruined by such an interruption. The SideWinder X2 will continue print at exactly the same point where it was interrupted. While the SideWinder X2 delivers impressive performance, you will be surprised by the unnoticeable noise during operation. The noise level of the SideWinder X2 is about 33 decibels on average during printing. When I put the machine in operation, I actually had to go back and check a few times to see if the printer was still working. I can say that I'm very happy with the low noise level, especially when leaving the machine printing during the night. The Artillery SideWinder X2 has a very fast heat-up time of 1.5 minutes. Most other 3D printers in the same price range require 2 minutes or longer for such temperatures. This fast heat-up time is due to the PTFE-lined volcano hot end and the fast AC heating of the print bed. The SideWinder X2 has a pre-assembled double Z-axis with two dedicated stepper motors. They are also connected to each other at the top of the frame with a synchronizing tooth belt. This guarantees synchronized movement. Considering its performance, features, and price point, the SideWinder X2 offers excellent value for money. It's currently on the market for $349. In my opinion, this machine provides a comparable print quality to higher-priced 3D printers, making it attractive to everyone on a budget. This printer's reliability, ease of use, and large build volume make it suitable for a wide range of applications. Now that I've mentioned all the positive features about this machine that I was really happy with, I would like to share with you some of the cons and the issues I faced when using the X2, and how I solved some of the problems. Although X2 features automatic bed leveling, I would strongly suggest to do manual bed leveling twice before moving on to doing auto bed leveling. Here is the print quality before and after doing manual bed leveling twice. My first print was all bumpy and not smooth and has springs all over the print. If you face any issues, you can always contact the Artillery customer service for support. They are truly professional and happy to help. Adjust the inclination of the print bed. They are large enough to be turned comfortably, but unfortunately the problem with the rotary screw is that in four places where they touch the print bed, the AC heating is not applied to the print bed. This results in cold spots on the print bed above the four rotary screws, where the print bed adhesion is worse than the rest of the bed. This can be easily solved by using PEI magnetic metal bed to distribute heat homogeneously. Because the X2 is a tall Cartesian style printer with no additional supports, there is a noticeable zero-bolt on tall prints over 10 cm. However, this can be fixed with a simple printed brace or purchasable rod stabilizer. Both options stabilize the printer and reduce zero-bolt issues. In conclusion, the SideWinder X2 3D printer is a reliable and feature-rich printer that offers excellent performance, ease of use, and print quality. With its sturdy construction, large build volume, and compatibility with various filaments, it caters to the needs of both beginners and more experienced users. The SideWinder X2 is affordable price point further enhances its value for money, making it a highly recommended option for those seeking versatile and reliable 3D printers.